I have it there. So, hi Dale, hi Anne. Okay, my voice is shot to pieces. I've just been doing some raucous numbers, you know, and I thought I would change over to an electric to an acoustic and finish there for the cover version, because it is a cover version, even though I did the music to it, of your amazing poem, Emily, Where's the Sun Go To at Night? Which I always think of in allegorical terms, you know, thinking of this young man, my amazing son, and your fantastic brother, Dylan. A lot of people ask me, actually, online, well, all the way through, how I go from doing these paint-peeling, screaming rock songs and protest songs that I do. And then, you know, so I lose, every time I do a ballad, you know, I get in a certain amount of audience, you know, new people come along. And then the next day I've been recording some, you know, some screamers and stuff, and they're like, oh, what? I'm a gentle bloke, you know. And sometimes it goes the other way, so all these people that come along and subscribe to me and send me nice comments saying, wow, rock and roll, man, and all this stuff, you know. And the next day I'm doing something more reflective and rueful and stuff. And, yeah. Where's our punk rocker gone, you know? But it's been that way for 40 years. I understand why people don't understand how I do so many categories, and I don't understand why people think I can't or more importantly shouldn't do this kind of that kind of stuff. I always look at it this way. Hedy Ledbetter sang raucous parchment farm blues, and they sang children's songs, and if it's good enough for Ledbetter, it's good enough for anyone, because that's the benchmark. Anyway, so that's not as well tuned as I would have liked it to have been.
Does it sink into the sky's lake? Well, what kind of mysterious shape would that make? Does the sun hold? I guess I need to wait to be told. Does it turn into the moon? They say if I'm patient, I'll find out soon. Those glowing bright skies, but it's a clever old moon gives us the tides. Where does the sun go to at night? Where does it hide until daylight?
Dylan, I hope you'll see this somewhere down the line and stuff. I just want to say what Daddy's doing here. I've told you this story many times. This is kind of illustration. I've not seen this particular clip here. This is early 2013, so you're 5 months old. Remember how I used to say, we used to go shopping together every Saturday morning, or we went everywhere together, you know, didn't we? And the day that, and I used to put you in the cart, some of them have little baby bits on the back, so you'd be sitting, lying down in there. And I've told you this several times, this anecdote about how I was walking you around one Saturday morning, and I would be talking to you all the time, and I'd be saying, well, you know, should we get whatever, you know, should we get these biscuits, and what are we going to get for Sunday dinner, should we get some salmon or anything? Traumatizing you there. Well, here we go. What a difference 11 years makes, huh? Yeah. Anyway, so I was doing this and walking around with you, talking to you, and this guy came up, this old fella. I mean, probably younger than me, but. And he said, do you think he can understand what you're saying? And I said, well, I think he understands that his father is talking to him, giving him attention. And he walked away like it never occurred to him that, you know, you could hear the tone of my voice and see the happy expression on my face and the love in my eyes, you know, and the fact we were interacting. And obviously not this bit here where I'm singing to you. And you're going, what is up with Daddy? This is just after I, you know, and before, I'm not even playing a ballad to you, am I? What am I playing now? And anyway, but previously, just before this started, where I'm reading you a book, it looked like it was your farm animal book. And then you're on your jumperoo. So you don't understand what I'm saying. So I'm sitting there and I'm reading the book to you, and I'm probably pointing at the animals and everything. Sadly, although I was able to salvage these discs, these are from the disc, but it's on in this format, Chance Friendless. There's no sound, I'm afraid they're both silent. That illustrates my point there. So when you have children of your own, and what are you now, 11, so don't leave it too long, okay? certainly don't leave it till you're 52 like I did. Ah, man. You know, but you can see how you're reacting to me there. You know, so you don't know what I'm saying. I could be reading you the ingredients of a sauce bowl. But the fact is, you know, you're seeing your parent is giving you attention, wants to be with you, is engaging with you, that his face is smiling, you know, can't stop smiling, and his eyes are smiling. And you can see that he wants to, you know, involve you in everything he's doing, etc., 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 etc. But then you get the gist there of what I was doing. Then you're advancing along in your jumper with your cot. What's that in the background? This is your sleepy chair, I guess. That's actually downstairs in the kitchen at the moment. I climbed up in the loft recently and pulled it out of the loft. And it's like a swing chair and everything, and much though I love having you in my arms as often as possible. You know, you just have to go and do things, you know. A lot of adults will actually hide behind that, say, I can't, got no time for yoga, go make the dinner, you know, or do this, you know. And stuff. But sometimes, you know, I did have to make the dinner and stuff, so I put you in this, and I had three settings, and you would lock away and play you this soothing just go and sit in it myself now. Anyway, so that song is Where Does the Sun Go To at Night, which is a poem by my amazingly talented daughter for school homework. This is how talented my daughter is, and innovative and creative. Both my children are so fantastic and creative. And at 9 years old, she was given a project on space. The class was given a project on space. And they had to write something about space. And Emily, we were on the telephone, and she's telling about this. And she said, I'm going to do it as a poem, Daddy. Came back to paper. I won't be long, she said. I'm going to call it, Where's the Sun Go To at Night? She came up with a title and said, I'm going to do it as a poem. Off, back, pen and paper. Where's the Sun Go To at Night? I need to know, all right? And then she said, well, you can help if you want to, Daddy. So I made some suggestions, and then we were like, you know, he's only written 1,500 songs. What does he know? You know, kind of thing. But I did come up with the next line. Does it sink into the sky's lake? I think Emily started the line off, and I came up with a bit about the, being the sky's lake. And then Emily came up with what kind of mysterious shapes would that make? But I did put the music to it. Well, it's a cover version, and whenever I sing it, I always think of, you know, it works on many levels. It obviously works on a certain level when you're 9 years old. But if you think about it, as you get older, and if you look at the metaphorical context of it, it applies in many, many ways, you know. And in fact, it's almost a rumination on how time passes us by, really, you know. Where does the sun go to? And I was, because I've always tried to say to my children as well, sometimes, you know, when they call and I say, I think, oh, that's really bad, Daddy. I won't go into the details. There's other songs about that. And I try and, you know, it's heartbreaking to see, but I always try and stress to them. And to anyone else. Darkness falls on us all for 8 hours a day. But the sun always comes along. The darkness always gets taken away. Just a matter of rising out those hours. And eventually, that nice bright dawn, when these wonderful singing birds comes along. So, every tune, if you're not my children, if you're not my children, if you're not my children, I apologize for rambling on a little bit there. Thank you for indulging me. I will leave you now. Do whatever you've got to do for the rest of your evenings. Dylan Emily, Revue 2, that loves you with all his heart and soul and every fiber of his being.